Welcome, everybody. This is an excellent turnout, so that's awesome. My name is Aaron Brubaker, the principal here at Wellsville Secondary School. Very honored to be able to welcome you to this year's holiday winter concert here for our high schoolers, our 9th through 12th students. Of course, I've got to start with our housekeeping item for the fire exits. As you probably know, there's two exits at the back of the auditorium and one down to your left. In the case of an emergency, just make your way to the closest exit and out down the stairs and out of the building in kind of an orderly fashion. As unlikely as that may be, I've got to mention it. I'd like to do some recognitions before we start. First and foremost, we have kind of a new team approach with the decorating this year. So if you look at the whole space, our art department and our music department kind of combined forces and did a great job to make the space look fantastic. So I'd like to thank Mrs. Babbitt and Mrs. McNulty and a bunch of kids who all banded together to get that to look great. So we thank them a lot. We couldn't pull a show off like this without the behind the scenes of the AV crew, Mr. Fontaine and his crew who run the sounds and the lights. You know, they're the first to show up, the last to leave, and the behind the scenes crew is what makes this come off. You don't see a lot of that, and so they certainly get some recognition as well. We have our ushers club. Mrs. Willard and Mrs. Gilfer have been helping us out for a long time with the programs and kind of all the stuff that goes on at the back here as you're coming in, so we'd like to thank them as well. I'd like to thank our music instructors, Mr. Joslin with band, Mrs. Susano with choir, and then we have Mr. Luthart, who is new to us this year with our orchestra department, doing a fantastic job, so we'd like to thank them. I think probably most of all, I'd like to thank you all, friends and families, for supporting your students, both with the practice that they do here at school, outside of school, during class, lessons, and all of the work that goes on. Kids couldn't do all that without support from home, so we appreciate that greatly. And last, and certainly not least, the students for all the hard work that they're doing to make the show spectacular, so we really appreciate their hard work as well. And with that, I'm just going to finish by saying have a great evening. We hope you enjoy the show. They've got a fantastic show planned, and happy holidays. Thank you.
Thank you. That was Watermelon Man by Herbie Hancock, written in the early 1960s. While the rest of the band joins us, I just want to mention how much of a pleasure it is to work with an outstanding group of students each and every day. I can't think of a better way to start my day other than senior band, first period. Okay, our next piece we're going to play for you is called Arabian Dances. The program notes on my score reads this. After a long day's journey, the nomads set camp for the evening. As the sun casts final searing rays on the desert landscape, a campfire roars to life and celebration begins. As the sky darkens, the festivities grow wilder and wilder until eventually three groups of revelers take turns dancing at the edge of the fire, each trying to outdo the other. Finally, the entire tribe joins, dancing wildly for hours until the campfire dims and the morning grows near. So this is our version of Arabian Dances. I'm going to ask Kaylee Fuller, she's a senior flute player, to come on up. She's going to introduce the next song, The Last of the Pony Express.
A March 1860 ad in a California newspaper read, "Wanted, young, skinny, wiry fellows, not over 18, must be expert riders, willing to risk death daily, orphans preferred." On April 3rd, 1861, the Central Overland California and Pikes Peak Express Company began a bold new enterprise to provide the fastest mail delivery between the Midwest and California by horseback in the hopes of gaining a $1 million government mail contract. Nicknamed the Pony Express, this new service ran day and night from April 1860 to October of 1861. Once a week from April to mid-June 1860, a twice a week from mid-June to late October of 1861, 183 men were known to have ridden this dangerous and challenging route for the Pony Express. At a pay of $100 a month, these men rode 75 to 100 miles per day, changing horses every 10 to 15 miles. 400 horses were purchased to stock the Pony Express, and a system of 165 stations were built along the 2,000-mile trail. The mail route took 10 days in summer and 16 days in winter. The record for run of the route was 7 days and 17 hours for the delivery of Lincoln's inaugural address in 1860. This is our rendition of The Last Ride of the Pony Express, composed by David Schaefer.
Thank you.
and it gets hot with a suit on. Our last song, Deck the Halls with Chips and Salsa. It's just that. Deck the Halls with a little salsa twist. Once we finish our last song, that's our last song, right? Yeah, that's our last song. We're going to take like a minute or so we can reset the stage for Mr. Luther's debut conducting the high school orchestra. High school orchestra.
Good evening. Before we end our section of the concert, I just want to thank all of you for coming out and supporting our music program. The last three and a half months, have been crazy and incredibly fun and rewarding in many different ways for me. And I can't be more thankful than I am now. I can't imagine, it's been this much fun 3 months into this job. I can't imagine what it's going to be like with a couple years under my belt. So thank you, orchestra. Thank all of you for coming out. I hope you enjoy our last tune. It's Can't Help Falling in Love.
Thank you. us all seem to say, no cares away. Christmas is here, no need to chance it. Merry, merry, merry Christmas. Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Thank you for saying.
We just have one more piece left for you tonight. Thank you so much for coming out and supporting your children in their musical endeavors. We so appreciate you being here. I always say I have the nicest students. I mean, maybe you don't think so, but I think so. Maybe they act differently around you, but I really couldn't say enough about these high school kids that I work with. They're just amazing, and they bring me joy every day. So that's a testament to you as their parents. There's also just a few people that I'd like to mention. I'd like to thank Eric Morehouse, running the sound. He comes down at least 2 weeks before and runs everything for us every day. So we really appreciate all the hard work that he's put into these concerts. I'd also like to give a quick shout out to Diane Willard. I don't know if she's in here, but for my sixth grade concert, she was coming in on the weekends, getting stuff ready for me and running our haze machine and all that. So just very thankful for her. And I'd also like to give a huge, huge thank you to our accompanist, Joanne Brown. She also comes in weeks ahead of time to prepare the kids for this concert, and she really does a lot, and she's amazing. We couldn't do it without her. So if we could just give all those people a round of applause. We hope you enjoy our last piece, White Winter Hymnal. And just so you know, we will be setting a few mics for our next performance. So just sit tight for that. just want to make a quick announcement before Wave gets started. I accidentally switched around the soloists in the program. I don't know why. It's not like I have a lot going on right now or anything. But the first song is going to be Madison Baker and Alexa Stuck. And the second song is Maddie Marisep and Oliver Brammer. Just want to make sure we got that corrected.
You must think that I'm stupid. You must think that I'm a fool. You must think that I'm new to this. But I have seen this all before. Never really get too close to you, even when I mean the most to you. In case you
Thank you again for coming. Have a wonderful holiday season and a wonderful night. Thank you.